Barcelona when the Mercedes-Benz CLS class initially landed in 2004. It was the start of the alleged four-entryway car development. Regardless of whether the wording still annoys individuals, the style itself has taken off and even impacted SUVs. However, as the class advances, Mercedes has constantly kept its CLS consistent with the first. Presently in its third era, the 2019 CLS holds a great part of the look of its ancestors, maybe in light of the fact that to transform it a lot of would destroy it. In spite of the fact that it won't not appear as though at all things considered, there are a great deal of changes that move the new CLS into the future, especially in the engine. As we arranged to get in the driver's seat out of the blue, Peter Cole, the man accountable for vehicle testing for the CLS, let us know, we have culminated the first. We went to the grand heaps of the Catalonian farmlands to see with our own eyes. The central purpose of the styling changes was to evacuate diverting visuals for a cleaner general look. The profile still bears a swoopy outline with a long nose and small rise of a nursery behind it, however the sheet metal is smoother and rounder, with no significant sharp wrinkles to center in around. CLS fashioner Hugh Haller depicted it as Design Philosophy 2.5, which he clarified this way, leave a line off. In the event that it looks great, leave a different line off. This reasoning works for us, as we observe the new CLS's profile to be a close ideal refining of the four-entryway roadster idea. In advance, we cherish the way the hood is totally isolated from the lighting, encompassed on all sides by body. The sharp nose goes to a forceful point before the vehicle, and the thin headlights look spotless and quick all alone. The grille, with its jewel outline, and the practical air bits up along the base and along the edges, include some visual intrigue. This auto has a drag coefficient of 0.29, and it looks each piece that elusive. In the back, the level deck flips up into a clean little spoiler, which gives downforce and steadiness at higher velocities. The new two-piece taillights are separated by the opening of the storage compartment, and they look lively and rakish, a fitting visual finale as the auto sneaks past you. Contingent upon the adaptation of the CLS, it is possible that maybe a couple debilitate tips on either side are isolated by a back diffuser. The auto's inside feels like a huge refresh. Gone is the dedication to stodgy, traditionalist styling of times past. The CLS receives the inside treatment spearheaded by the 2017 E-Class, which grasped the most recent innovation. The new CLS's inside at long last feels similarly as attractive and appealing as the engaged outside. Inside, the wave line, featured by State of Mind lighting, draws your eye from one entryway, down the dash and over the other entryway and even over the back entryways in the event that you crane your neck. Before the driver, the CLS is refreshed with a couple of advanced screens under a solitary, consistent sheet of glass, an exquisite joining contrasted and the past solid look of the focal tablet. One fills in as the instrument board, alternate as an infotainment show. The calfskin extended over the dash and over the seats of our analyzer's designo inside is smooth and delicate. Maybe the most intriguing visual element inside the CLS, however, is the fly turbine look of the round, lit up air vents. Lighting around the handle in the middle changes from blue when blowing cool air to red while giving warmth. Aside from the absence of overhead airspace, the inside of the CLS feels especially spacious. There's a great deal of room between the front tenants, and it's sufficiently wide for a center seat in the back of first for the CLS. That low-through roof line means you taller people should remove your cattle rustler cap before you get in. At 6 feet tall, moving our seat as low as it would go allowed us to disregard the headroom issues after a bit. The most captivating change to the CLS isn't a stylish one. Rather, it's in the engine, as an inline-six aero motor with a 48-volt half-and-half framework. By training, we'd call this a mellow half-breed framework, yet that descriptor simply doesn't do equity to how vital a part it plays in both the CLS 450 and the AMG 53. By and by, the inline-six in the CLS 450 is genuinely a delight to utilize. For a certain something, it sounds intriguing. The tad of commotion that advances in from in the engine is extremely mechanical and controlled. It's extremely simple to picture the small, consummately coordinated individual blasts ticking off in their separate chambers. There's an encouraging smoothness in that arrangement as far as putting shut down, first commonplace to your creator from a 1999 Jeep Cherokee's 4.0-liter inline-six yet with a family and Mercedes vehicles extending back to the 1920s. An odd mental examination, maybe, yet it shows what this motor speaks to us, a workhorse. On the off chance that you need to bring a more profound plunge into the CLS motor's specialized subtle elements, there's a whole other world to peruse. Mercedes' new Inline-6 truly is an intriguing engine as far as innovation, well-being, productivity, cooling and NVH. The incorporation of the 48-volt tech boost framework, with its extra 22 pull and 184 pound-feet of torque, yes, you read that effectively, is a piece of what makes this powertrain so fulfilling to utilize. Regularly, mellow half and half frameworks feel latent, unnoticed by the driver with the exception of when the motor shivers to life when the stoplight turns green. Exceptionally, Mercedes exhibits this framework to the driver with a solitary, straight check on the instrument board, with the meter moving to one side amid charging, and ideally amid boosting. This enables the driver to compare the speeding up they feel to what the framework is really doing. It feels fun-loving, and brings into this gas-fueled games auto a smidgen of the delight experienced by F-drivers. Small steps. Whatever remains of the driving flow are well known. The 9-speed programmed transmission moves easily, rapidly and discreetly in the 450. The directing is regularly uncommunicative, yet we didn't discover any trouble in pointing the smooth CLS along the limited mountain streets of Catalonia. However, a portion of the transport driver's close monastery to Montserrat appeared to have considerably more certainty than us. Indeed, even in the rain, putting our foot to the floor in our AWD test auto was met with perfect steadiness. In the AMG CLS 53, everything is more opened up. Yield is supported to 429 drive and 384 pound-feet with the assistance of a twin-scroll turbocharger electric helper compressor. It likewise profits by a similar transitory power knock from the EcBoost starter alternator. From the driver's seat, the sound of this turbocharged variant is more ruled by the fumes. The movements from the AMG-tuned 9-speed transmission are met with blats from the four fumes tips in the back. The 0-60 mph run arrives in a smart 4.5 seconds, 3/10 of a tick quicker than in the 454-matic. The guiding feels more tightly, more responsive and even more open about the street surface. We were capable, on only several events, to evoke only a small piece of squirreliness from the backside while quickening out of a tight, wet corner. Mercedes-Benz has been a pioneer with regards to keen driver help frameworks, and now journey control is getting much more intelligent. The CLS acquires its Distronic innovation from the S-Class. It has versatile journey control and path following. The flawless strap here, however, is that it will consequently alter for changing pace braking points, and it even envisions bends in the street and backs off for them. On the breezy Spanish expressways, we were genuinely inspired to see the auto explore corners individually. It did as such carefully, and at bring down cornering speeds than we'd have kept up under manual control. No curveballs there, as security and solace starred things out.